Now that our vendors are set up, we can now start entering bills from vendors for services that we have received. When QuickBooks uses the word bill, QuickBooks means invoice that we receive from a vendor. You probably remember in the customer section, the invoice was a document that we sent to a customer to ask the customer for something that they promised to pay. A bill is the same thing, except when we use QuickBooks, we use the word bill when the vendor sends the document to us to ask us to pay for something we owe the vendor. So the word bill and the word invoice mean the same thing, but in QuickBooks, it's called a bill if you received it from a vendor. It's called an invoice if you send it to a customer. It's very easy to record a bill that you receive from a vendor. The window is very simple and it will be demonstrated in a moment. But let's think about what happens in your QuickBooks records when you enter a bill and record the information from a bill that you received from a vendor. Well, as soon as you record a bill, like you record any transaction, the chart of accounts and the general ledger will be updated and that will reflect on the trial balance. But from the very same bill, the vendor records, which are separate from the general ledger, will also be updated. Here's the example of our first bill. Imagine on April 13th, we received the electric bill from Con Edison. Imagine it's $1,000 and it's bill number 6161. Right now, electric expense is not listed in the trial balance, even though electric expense is in the chart of accounts. Accounts payable is also not listed yet in our trial balance, but accounts payable is in our chart of accounts. After we record this first electric bill for $1,000, electric expense should show up on the trial balance for the first time as $1,000, and accounts payable should also show up on the trial balance for the very first time for $1,000. That would be how that bill would affect the general ledger and the chart of accounts. Remember, that same bill also affects the vendor records. Just like the customers have a customer balance detail, the vendors have a vendor balance detail. This report shows the amount we owe to each individual vendor. So if we record that electric bill should show up as $1,000 that we owe specifically to Con Edison. All we have to do is record the bill once, and the vendor records here and the general ledger trial balance will change from the same bill. Let's take a look. Before we record the bill, let's take a look at the trial balance. And you remember there are many numbers in the trial balance that have accumulated from the previous videos that we learned. But there is no accounts payable right now, and there is no electric expense right now. After we record this bill, that will change. If you wish to record if you wish to enter a bill from a vendor, click Vendor, Enter Bill. And of course, the Enter Bill window opens up. The date of the bill is April 13. The vendor is Con Edison. The reference number on the bill is 6161, and the amount is $1,000. Now, Con Edison is a new vendor on our list, so QuickBooks does not know which expense goes with this vendor. So we go down here to the bottom left, just as we learned in the previous write a checks window. We have to put the expense that we're entering the bill for. Click here and you get the entire chart of accounts. The expense that we're recording is electric expense. This is what the information would look like on the bill when we record it and read it from the bill. When we click Save and Close, we notice accounts payable shows up for the very first time as $1,000, and electric expense also shows up for the very first time as $1,000. We can also open the vendor reports, which the choice here is vendor balance detail. And as you notice on the vendor balance detail, we have one bill, from Con Edison, bill number 6161, we owe specifically Con Edison $1,000. Now let's enter a second bill and see what happens. On April 14th, we received the repair bill from Rex Repair. The amount is $2,000 and the bill is 6262. Can you imagine how this bill would affect the trial balance and the general ledger and the chart of accounts when we record it? Well, right now there is no repair expense in the trial balance. However, when we enter our first repair bill for $2,000, repair expense will show up on the trial balance as $2,000. Right now, accounts payable is only $1,000 from the electric bill. However, if we record another bill from another vendor for $2,000, account payable will become $3,000. If you want more detail about why accounts payable is $3,000, you would look at the vendor balance detail. Before the repair bill, we only owed Con Edison $1,000. But now we're entering a repair bill from Rex Repair for $2,000. That means that the total money that we owe to all vendors after we enter this repair bill will be $3,000, which is the same as accounts payable in the trial balance. Let's take a look. When you look at the trial balance before we enter this bill, account payable is only $1,000 and there is no repair expense. To enter the bill from the vendor, click Vendor, Enter Bill. Of course, we put the date April 14, the reference number 6262, the amount $2,000. So far, it's pretty easy. The vendor is Rex Repair. Now, we have to put the expense that's associated with this bill. However, repair expense is not on the list. It is not yet in the chart of accounts. But we learned in previous videos, you can add an expense or you can add an account at the moment you make the transaction. If you click this arrow and scroll all the way up to the top of the chart of accounts, you get the option for adding new. That means you can add the account at the moment you make the transaction. Notice the account type is already chosen as expense. That's because QuickBooks knows if you're adding an account from the Enter Bill window, probably you're adding an expense. When we click Continue, expense is already chosen for us as the account type. All we have to do is type in the name. Let's type it in capital letters so QuickBooks knows that it's an account that we added and not what QuickBooks added. When we click Save and Close, we have repair expense in our bill. And when we save and close the bill, notice accounts payable has increased to $3,000 and repair expense has shown up on the trial balance for the first time as $2,000. Remember, this bill did not only affect the chart of accounts and the trial balance, it also affected our vendor records, which we can check here in the vendor balance detail. As you can see, we still owe Con Edison $1,000 for the electric bill, but now we also owe Rex Repair $2,000 for the repair bill, which means the total we owe to all vendors is now $3,000 in the vendor balance detail, which is equal to accounts payable $3,000.